My name is Revelize, and this is the first episode of my Parse Paramedic series. Now, the reason I'm making this is because I have a bunch of good friends that are great players in Elder Scrolls Online, and they are stuck in the 20 to 35,000 damage per second range. And so the purpose of the Parse Paramedic series is really just to help you get up to above 50,000 damage per second. So I'm hoping through this series what I'm able to show you, we're going to be able to get your DPS up really nice and high. All right, so this first episode is going to be on light attack weaving. Now, there is a large misconception in the game about light attack weaving, and I still have not found a good website or a good video that really easily and simply explains light attack weaving and how to do it. So that's the purpose of this video. So I'm going to give it my best shot. If this video does end up helping you, please drop a comment below. So first things first, in order to do this, there are two really, really good add-ons that I recommend, and they're going to be really great training tools, and those are GCD Bar and Combat Metrics, okay? And I'm going to have a link for both of those in the description below, so please click that link and grab those. If you do not have them, it will make your light attack weaving life much easier. All right, so first things first. In Elder Scrolls Online, there is a global cooldown, all right? There's a 1 second global cooldown. And basically what that means is you can use one skill per 1 second, okay? And you cannot use skills faster than that. So every single skill in the game is bound by this global cooldown. Now, the important thing to keep in mind is that light attacks are not bound by this global cooldown, okay? So one skill can only be used once per 1 second. However, since light attacks are not bound by this global cooldown, you can actually put a light attack in between using your skills. So light attack weaving means you use a skill, you use another skill 1 second later, and in between using those two skills, you are light attacking. So that's basically what light attack weaving means. Now, really, in its most simple form, the way to light attack weave is just to left click before every single skill. So you left click and then hit your skill, as you see I'm doing. I'm left clicking, hitting my skill. Left clicking, hitting my skill. Except you want to do that way, way faster. So your goal is to be able to left click and hit your skill within 50 to 70 milliseconds of each other is really the prime range. If you don't want to worry about trying to figure out how much that is, basically what I'm saying is you want to left click and then hit your skill right after as fast as humanly possible. So go ahead and check this out. The way I recommend starting off to learn light attack weaving is to start with a spammable low resource skill. So the skill I'm going to use is elemental weapon, and all I'm going to do is just try to light attack weave by hitting this skill over and over and over again. It's really great just to start with one skill. It'll help remove a lot of the extra noise. Okay, so watch me here. I'm going to hit that skill, and you'll see that light attack shooting out between every skill. Now, this skill in itself does not shoot out any projectile, so that projectile you see shooting out is my light attack weaving, all right? So this is how you light attack weave. You want to hit one skill per 1 second, and then you want to left click before the skill and hit the skill so fast that you get that that light attack shooting out in between the skills. Okay, so the next question then is, how often do I hit the skill, right? Because this entire rotation revolves around hitting the skill once every 1 second. So if you don't have that timing right, none of your other timing is going to be right. So I just mentioned GCD bar, and again, that link's in the description below, and I'll show you what that looks like. It's just this little bar right here, and its only purpose in the game, its only function is whenever you hit a skill, it starts a 1 second countdown, okay? So that red bar emptying out is a 1 second long countdown. So that really helps you pace it out, because your goal, again, is to hit a skill every 1 second. So ideally, you're going to left click, hit your skill, and then as that bar empties, you want to left click and hit your skill again, because that means 1 second has passed. So I want you to watch me do this rotate, this light attack weaving with just this one elemental weapon skill, and watch the bar and notice the timing. So I'm going to start out here. Now notice every single time the bar empties, I left click and use my skill again, okay? Every single time it's about to empty, I left click, use my skill, left click, use my skill, and every single time it empties. Now this is light attack weaving in its most simple form, is being able to hit a skill and weave a light attack in every single second. All right, so that's what it looks like again, in its most basic form. So the next question is then, okay, well, that's all great and well. That's how I weave with elemental weapon. What about my other skills? Actually, it doesn't change at all between skills. Every single skill in your rotation, light attack weaving is simply left clicking right before using the skill. Okay, so no matter what skill it is, I want a light attack and then hit that skill super close together. So I'll do the same thing with a different skill. Okay, I have Blockade of Storms here on my back bar, so I'll hit Blockade of Storms and light attack weave in between each Blockade of Storms. So watch out for that electrical bolt shooting out, and that's my light attack. Okay, so I'm hitting electrical storms, and then between every single electrical storm, you see that bolt of lightning shooting out. That is my light attack weaving in there in between my skill usage. All right, so see, it works exactly the same no matter what the skill is. So yeah, light attack weaving is as simple as that. Just simply hitting left click before every single skill you use very, very quickly together, and grab that GCD bar, and that's going to really help your timing. I recommend spending a good amount of time on a parse dummy, just doing the one skill light attack, until you're fully comfortable doing that before trying to light attack before every single skill in your full rotation. As far as what full rotation to use, that's something I'm going to be talking about in the future parse paramedic videos. So if you want to see certain rotations, check those out. Next up, we're going to get into some more advanced topics when it comes to light attack weaving. So you say, okay, this is perfect. I know now when to light attack weave when I use a skill. But what about when I weapon swap? Doesn't that mess things up? Weapon swapping while light attack weaving is honestly, in my opinion, one of the hardest things to do in a rotation. It's something I still do not have down perfectly. However, I can show you exactly what you need to do in order to make that timing happen. So as you're looking at this bar that we just talked about, the GCD bar, your goal when having to swap between bars is to hit left click, hit your skill, and then swap all very, very close together. So it's gonna be left click skill swap. Okay? And then and your goal is to be fully swapped to your next bar to hit whatever your next skill is, by the time the timer is only halfway down. So what it would look like is left click weapons left click skill weapon swap, timer's halfway down, and then you can just wait till it empties all the way out and left click and skill again. Okay? So I'm going to do that for you now. So here we go. I'm going to just swap between bars, and you'll see that light attack shoot out. All right, so as you can see here, I am left clicking skill and weapon swapping all very close together, and my weapon swap is complete by the time the bar is halfway empty. If you do not time it so the bar is halfway empty when you weapon swap, if you do not get it fast enough, excuse me, that the bar is not over halfway empty, then the light attack will not shoot out. So I'll show you what that looks like. So if I hit a skill and not light attack till now, then as you can see, not a perfect example, but in general, if you do not get it, if you do not weapon swap by the time it's halfway empty, it's very hit or miss on whether the light attack is going to shoot out. So you're really only going to get half the time. So the ideal range is to be able to left click skill weapon swap by the time the bar is halfway down, and then of course do wait all the way to the end of the timer before hitting your next skill on the bar you swap to, and do your normal rotation. So that is weapon swapping. The next thing that you need to know is how to calculate your light attack ratio. Now, your light attack ratio is a really good benchmark when you're doing a parse to determine, was I truly light attack weaving as good as I could have been? Could I be doing a better job? Now, this is where combat metrics comes into play. Combat metrics is the second add-on I mentioned at the beginning of this video. Again, the link is in the description. So if I go into chat and type CMX, It pulls up this. Now, this is the last parse. This is the parse I have pulled up right now, okay? And what this is basically a scorecard of your parse. It helps you figure out what went wrong, what went right, that sort of thing. Now, for light attack weaving, what we care about is the light attack amounts. So, as you see here, there was on my front bar, my fire staff light attacked for 73 times. On my back bar, my lightning light attack or light staff attacked for 27 times. So, in total, 27 light attacks on my back bar plus 73 attacks on my front bar. I did 100 light attacks in total during this parse. Now, you'll see up here to the left. Active time. This is how long the parse took. Okay, so the parse took 110 seconds total. I did 100 light attacks in the 110 seconds total. So I would take 100 divided by the 110 total seconds, and that gives you about 0.92. And that's your light attack ratio. Basically, how many light attacks are you doing per second? And I'm doing 0.9 light attacks per second. So almost one light attack per 1 second. Now, in a perfect world, you should have that all the way. So you're doing one light attack per 1 second. This is not a perfect world, of course. So your goal is to get as close to like 0.99 as you can. To give you a reference point, if you are able to get above 0.7 when you calculate that out, that means you're doing it right. You're well on your way to getting higher. Okay, you're going in the right direction. You're gonna be able to probably hit about high 40K DPS at this point if you're able to make it to 0.7. 0.8 is really your goal. You should try to get above 0.8. If you're able to get above 0.8, that means you should be able to hit 50K damage per second. Okay, so 0.8 and higher, as long as you have your gear perfected and everything, and 810 CP should lead to 50,000 damage per second. So the higher you can get above 0.8, the higher your DPS will go. Really, anything higher above 0.8. With a really solid rotation is just how high above 50,000 damage per second can you go? So that's really all light attack weaving is. It's just like I mentioned before, left clicking really fast before hitting each skill. So that's the extent of this video. I really hope that that this guide helps you to figure out the light attack weaving. I know when I started playing, it took me many months to figure out the light attack timing and the light attack weaving. So hopefully this guide kind of helps shorten that learn time down from several months for you. If this video was helpful, if you enjoyed it, if you already knew all this, but you took the time to watch it anyway, I really appreciate that. Feel free to hit the like button and to subscribe if you want to see more Parse Paramedic episodes, where I'm going to continue to help you get above 50,000. I'm going to talk through actual rotations that you use now since you know how to light attack weave. In the meantime, thank you so much for joining me. It has been a true pleasure spending these last few minutes with you, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day.